everyone, welcome to my channel Dr. Nisha Garg. I have authored textbook of endodontics and textbook of operative dentistry, and all thanks to your love and appreciation for motivating me to start this channel. In this, we'll discuss different topics of dentistry in very easy way. You can also message me the topic you want me to discuss. So let's start with another session of principles of tooth preparation. See, in the previous video, we discussed about the terminology related to tooth preparation, line and point angles of different cavities. And in this video, we'll be discussing about the stages of tooth preparation, which include the initial and the final tooth preparation stage. So let's start. See, tooth preparation involves a systematic approach which is based on the mechanical and physical principles, which should be followed in an orderly sequence. Basically, the tooth preparation is divided into two stages. Each of them consists of many steps, and each step should be done to the perfection, but few modifications can be made in these steps. See the stages of tooth preparation. Stage 1, it is the initial cavity preparation stage, which involves the outline form, primary resistance form, primary retention form, and convenience form. Stage 2 of the tooth preparation is final tooth preparation stage, which involves the removal of any remaining enamel, infected dentine, or restorative material if indicated. Then we provide the pulp protection if indicated. Then secondary retention and the resistance form. After this, we do the procedures for finishing the external walls of the tooth preparation. And finally, we clean and inspect the tooth preparation for restoration. Now, first of all, we'll discuss about the outline form. Now, what does exactly an outline means? Outline means boundary or a gross plan showing the shape and size of something, but not the details. Similarly, you can see that outline form of tooth preparation here in this image. It's just an outline. We don't know the detailed features of this cavity basically. So if we look at the definition of outline form, it is defined as placing the preparation margins in the position they will occupy in the final tooth preparation, except for finishing enamel walls and the margins. This is what we were saying, that it doesn't cover the detailed features. It also includes preparing the initial depth of 0.2 to 0.8 mm into the dentine. Now coming to the principles of outline form. See, there are few general principles on which an outline form is established irrespective of type of tooth preparation. These principles are basically removal of all weakened and friable tooth structure during the tooth preparation, removal of all undermined enamel, that is the enamel which has been undermined by caries. We have to incorporate all faults in the preparation, and we should place the margins of preparation in a position to afford the good finishing of the restoration. See, if we don't remove all weakened and friable tooth structure or undermined enamel, and we don't place the margins of preparation on a healthy tooth structure, our preparation will have unsupported enamel, which may cause the marginal discrepancies in the restoration and may increase the chances of restoration failure. Now, while making the outline form, we should keep in mind certain features so as to have a successful restoration. For example, we need to preserve the cuspal strength. See, we just can't cut the tooth over enthusiastically because it will compromise the strength of the tooth. So, it's very important to preserve the cuspal strength. Similarly, we need to preserve the marginal ridge strength so as to have the strong marginal ridge which can bear the stresses of occlusal forces. The another thing which we need to keep in mind is to minimize the buccolingual extension. Now, what does it mean? See, this is the buccal side and this is the lingual side. We shouldn't overly cut the tooth structure like this. See, this is the narrowest part of the cavity, that is the isthmus. The width of isthmus should be 1/5 to 1/4 of intercuspal distance for amalgam and 1/3 in case of cast metal restorations. This will preserve the tooth strength of the tooth structure. The next feature is that if the distance between two folds is less than 0.5 mm, it's always better to connect them to make one single preparation rather than keeping two separate cavities with very less amount of healthy tooth structure between two. For example, you can see here the two cavities, the two pits involved in maxillary first molar, so mesial and the distal. But if the enamel, the healthy enamel between these two is very less, it's always suggested to join them. Because the weakened and the unsupported enamel, which will be present between these two preparations, may compromise the success of the restoration. And now coming to the depth of the cavity. See, we should extend our preparation 0.2 to 0.8 mm into the dentine, and the minimum depth of preparation for amalgam should be 1.5 to 2 mm. Now this minimum 1.5 to 2 mm depth for amalgam is provided to have the sufficient bulk of amalgam so as to prevent the fracture of the restoration. It provides a strength to the restoration. Next is using enameloplasty wherever indicated. In the upcoming slides, I'll be telling you what is enameloplasty, its indication and significance. Now coming to the outline form for pit and fissure lesions. Here, remove all defective portion and extend the preparation margins to the healthy tooth structure. See, we have already seen in the principles that removal of all weakened and friable tooth structure, undermined enamel and incorporate all faults in the preparation. So during this, rather than being straight, the outline form should form a smooth curve so as to preserve as much strong cusps as possible. This is called circumventing the cusps. Next is removal of all unsupported enamel rods or the weakened enamel margins. Now coming to the depth of the cavity. The depth of the tooth preparation should be at least 1.5 to 2 mm so as to accommodate the bulk of the material. And it should be at least 0.2 mm into the dentine so as to have the advantage of cushioning effect of the dentine due to its property of resiliency. So this point we have already seen in the previous slides that we should join two cavities if less than 0.5 mm of enamel is present between them. The next point is that we should avoid placing the preparation margins in high stress bearing areas like cuspal eminences, marginal ridges, etc. Because constant play of the occlusal forces on restorative tooth interface may result in the restoration failure. Next is that we should involve all pit and fissures which cannot be managed by enameloplasty. Now what is enameloplasty? I'll be covering in the next slide. Next is that isthmus width should be 1/4 of intercuspal distance. Next is that we should extend the outline form to have the convenience form. Now what does it mean? This means that in lieu of conserving the tooth, we should not make the outline form too narrow to work upon with the instruments during tooth preparation as well as restoration. Now, if we look for the outline form of class 2 cavities, apart from the above mentioned basic features like removal of all unsupported enamel, weakened enamel and placing the preparation margins on sound tooth structure, 3 to 4 more points we need to remember. What are these? The depth of axial wall. What is the axial wall? This wall, which is parallel to the long axis of tooth. Depth of the axial wall should be 0.2 mm to 0.8 mm into the dentine. The concept here is the same as we discussed earlier, that we should end our preparation into the dentine. Since axial wall is parallel to the external tooth surface, long axis of the tooth, so as we know that molars and premolars, they have the convex contour of the proximal surface. So similarly, our axial wall should be slightly convex so as to maintain the parallelism between with the external tooth surface. Gingival seat should be apical to the contact point. Because by this, the margins will be in the easily accessible area for self-cleansing. Gingival seed should also have the 0.5 mm clearance from the adjacent tooth. You can see here in this picture, the gingival seed is having at least 0.5 mm of clearance from the adjacent tooth. Now, what is the logic behind this? See, basically this clearance provides a convenience form. That is the space for proper accessibility, visibility, instrumentation and restoration of the tooth. Now let's come to the term enameloplasty. See, plasty literally means surgical repair or modification. So enameloplasty basically means removal of sharp and irregular enamel margins of the enamel surface by rounding or saucering it and converting into the smooth groove which makes it self-lensable area. So basically we are modifying a deep groove or fissure to a self-lensable area. It's specially indicated when caries are present in less than 1/3 thickness of the enamel. Now coming back to the features of establishing proper outline form, which stated that using enameloplasty wherever indicated. So what does it mean? It means if a deep fissure, which it can be made saucer shaped and self-cleansable with mild modification of the enamel, we should not include it in the outline form or preparation. So we can say that the outline form does not include the enameloplasty. Enameloplasty is the modification of enamel. It's not as the cavity preparation. So in this video, we have covered the first step, that is the outline form from the initial stage of the tooth preparation. In the upcoming videos, I'll be covering the other steps from the stages of tooth preparation. Thanks for watching this video. Kindly like and subscribe if you haven't done it yet. Thanks and take care.